Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today I'm going to give an introduction to the Troy data structure, and then we're going to talk about how to insert, search and delete in the Troy data structure. So what is Troy? Troy is a tree data structure used for storing collections of strings. If two strings have a common prefix, then they'll have a same ancestor in this tree. So if you have thousands of strings, or if you have hundreds of thousands of strings, then you can use Troy to store all the strings, and then it's very easy to search if a string exists in this collections of strings or not. So for example, Troy is an ideal data structure for storing a dictionary. Troy can also be used to do prefix-based search, and you can sort the strings lexicographically in the Troy. Another alternative is to use a hash table, but with hash table, you cannot do a prefix-based search, and also a regular hash table takes more space than a Troy. So next, let's talk about how to do insertion into a Troy. As I said before, Troy is a tree data structure, and this tree is made up of collections of Troy node. So every Troy node has two main components: a map where the keys character and value is Troy node. This is used to establish the parent-child relationship. And as we look through the example, it will be clear how it is being used. And the second one is Boolean end of word, indicating that the character representing this Troy node is an end of word or not. If your character set consists of just and lower cases or just upper cases, then you could replace this map with an array of size 26. But for generalization purpose, I'm using a map, so it also works with, for example, Unicode character set. So next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert this 5 words into a Troy. So initially, our Troy is a root, and root has an empty map. So this map here is empty, and then Boolean end of word is false. So then we're going to take this word ABCD and insert into this Troy. So our index is pointing to A, and we are at the root of this Troy node. So first we check is, is A present in the map of this root? So map of the root was empty, so A is not present. So then we create a new Troy node whose end of word is false. So this Boolean is false for this Troy node. And then we put A into this roots map, and for the value, we put the reference of this newly created Troy node. So effectively, we are creating a relationship like this. Then we increment this to B. And then we move here. So here we check, is B present in this Troy node, in the map of this Troy node? So again, since this was newly created, B is not present. So we create another Troy node with the value false, end of word value false, and put B in the map of this Troy node and point it to here. And then we move here and we increment this guy to C. So does C exist here? So again, this was a newly created Troy node, so its map is empty, so C does not exist. So we create C. And since C is the last character of this word, in this case, this value here will be true. And then we are going to put C in the map of this Troy node and point the reference to this Troy node. So this is how we inserted ABC into an empty Troy. So all we did was we started with root, put A in there, then we went to B, then we went to this guy, put B there, then we went to this here and put C there, and then finally we reached here. And since this was the last, this represents the last character of this word, we marked this end of word as true. So next, let's try to insert this word ABGL. So again, we start with A, and we start at root. Does root have A? So root does have A. So we jump here. Does this Troy node have B? So this Troy node does have B. So we jump here. And our pointer is now at G. So does this Troy node have G? It does not have G. So we're going to create a new Troy node whose end of word is false. And then we put G into the map and the reference of this in the value of the map here. And then we move one more. So this comes to L. Does L exist here? L does not exist here, so we are going to again create a new trinode. And since this is the last character of this word, this value will be true. And we're going to put L here and point this way. So now we are done inserting ABGL. So next, let's try to insert CDF. So again, we start at root. Does root have C? So root does not have C. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert C, create a new trinode whose end of word is false, and point this here. And then we jump here. And our index is now at D. Does this guy has D? It does not have D. So we create a new trinode with the value false and point this to D. And point put it in a map D and the reference of this trinode. And then move to F. So F does not exist here. So I'm going to create a new trinode. Its value will again be true because this is the last character of this word. And we'll say that F points this way. So finally, we are done inserting CDF. Next, let's try to insert ABCD. So again, we start from root. Again, we start with root. A is there, so we follow the pointer of A and reach here. So here, B is also there, so we follow the pointer and reach C. So C is also there, so we follow the pointer and reach this point. And in here, so now our pointer is pointing to D. So here, D does not exist. So what we're going to do is we're going to add D here. So add D, create a new trinode. Since it's a last character, mark this as true, add D and reference of this guy in the map here. And this is how we added D. Finally, let's add this word LMNN. So our root, again we've come back to root. L does not exist, so we're going to add L and we are going to create a new trinode for L. The value false, and then we move here. M does not exist, so we are going to add M and follow the trinode here, false, and then we move this to N. And N does not exist here, so we are going to create N and follow this trinode, and N jumps here. And since this is the last, N is the last character, this value becomes true. So this is how my try looks after I'm done inserting all this five words in my try. So as you can see, if two words have the same prefix, so for example this and this, in this case they share the common ancestors. So here ABC and ABGL, so they have same prefix, so they share this common ancestors, and from this point they bifurcate. So the time complexity for this is pretty straightforward to see. If the average length of the word is L and total number of words are N, then the time complexity is O of L into M. So next, let's look at how we are going to do a search in this try. There are two kinds of searches. Prefix-based search, where we are checking if there is at least one word which starts with a given prefix or not, and then the whole word search, where we are checking if the entire word exists in the try or not. So let's start with a prefix-based search and see if there is any string in this try which starts with AB. So we are at root, we check if the map, if this map at the root contains A or not. So it does contain A, so we jump to that trinode, so we reach here. Then here we check if the map in this trinode contains B or not. So it does contain B. So what this means is there is at least one word which does start with AB. So this should return true. There is no reason to look forward into this try. Let's look at LO. So again, we start at root, we check, does L exist in the map of the root or not? So L does exist, so we follow its trinode and reach here. Then we check, does O exist in this trinode or not. So AO does not exist here. So what that means is there is no word which starts with prefix LO. So this should return false. Let's try some whole word search. So let's try it start with LMN. So again, we are at root. We check, does root have L? So it does have L, so we follow here. Then we check, does this trinode have M? So it does have M, so we follow here. And then we check, does this trinode have N? So it does have N, so we follow here and reach this point. Once we reach this point, we check, is this node, is the end of word value here true or not? And that is very important. So end of word here is true. It means that L, M, and N does exist in this try. So this should return true. Let's do AB. So again, we start at root. We check A exists or not. So A does exist. We follow here. Then we are here and we check if B exists in this trinode or not. It does exist and we follow here. And now we look at the value here. So this value, end of word is false. It means that there is no entire word AB in this try. So this should return false. What about CDF? So we are at root. Does C exist? It does. So we move to move it follow its pointer reach D. Does D exist? It does. So we follow its pointer reach F. Reach this node. Does F exist in this node? It does exist. So we follow this pointer and reach here. And then the end of word is true. It means that CDF does exist. And finally GHR. Does G exist in the root node? G does not exist in the root node, which means that word GHI does not exist. So this should return false. So again, the time complexity is very simple. If the length of the word is L, then the time to search will be O of L. Next, let's look at how we're going to delete in this try. So delete also exists in two flavors. One is delete the entire word, or second is delete all the words which start with a given prefix. So we are going to try to delete this word ABC. We are at root. A exists here. We follow the link. Reach this point, this trinode. B exists here. Follow the link. Reach this trinode. C exists here. Follow the link and reach this trinode. So now we have to delete this word ABC and we are here. So the thing is, we cannot just delete this node. Why? Because if we remove this node from this trinode, then in that case, we would also lose the word ABCD, which is represented by this link here. So what we do is, since the map at this trinode is not empty, we cannot get rid of this this node. So all we do is turn this into false. Turn this end of word into false. So now if someone searched ABC, he would reach this point, and since this value is end of word is false, then they would say that ABC does not exist in this try, and that's how we deleted ABC. Next, we'll try to delete ABGL. So we start with root, follow link, reach this trinode, follow link, reach this trinode, and then from here we follow this G link and reach this trinode, and then from here we follow this L link and reach this trinode. This trinode has no children. Why? Because its map is empty. So then we can safely delete this guy, and then try to delete the nodes at the higher level too. So now that this is deleted, we can remove this character from its map. And as soon as we remove this character, now this map is empty, so we can delete this as well and go one level up here and delete this value G. Now we cannot delete this node because this has another link. This also has C. So at this point, we'll stop. So we are done deleting ABGL. Next, we'll delete ABCD. So we follow A, B, C, D, and we reach this node. So since this map is empty, we can just delete it and then go one level up and delete this character. And now this is empty, so we can delete it and reach one level up and remove C here. And now C is empty, so we can delete this. And similarly, now B will be removed. And now B is empty, so we can also delete this and remove A from here. So in this way, we deleted all the words, all the three words from this try. Again, the time complexity will be if average length is L and all the words are this number of words are n, then L into n will be the time complexity for deletion. So this is all I have to talk about try. There are tons and tons of applications of try, like doing prefix-based searching. If the values in this map can be values of characters in this map can be stored in a sorted format, then we can also sort this entire try lexographically. And in general, there are many applications which use try node, and probably we can discuss that in another video. So next, let's look at the code implementation for try data structure.
This is the try node we talked about before. So this is a map with a character and try node, and then end of the word. So first thing we do is we initialize our root in the constructor of try. Then we are going to do insert. So this is the iterative version of the insert, and we are trying to insert a word into the try. So first our current becomes root, then we iterate through characters one at a time in the word, and then we see if current has this character in its map. So children is nothing but this map. So we check if current has character in the map. If it does not, so if in that case node will be null, then we create a new try node and put this node and this character into the current's map. And then we set current is equal to node, and we keep doing it till we have characters in the word. And in the end, we just mark current's end of word as true, as we discussed before in the video. And then there is the recursive version, which is pretty much doing the same thing as in the iterative version, getting the node for the current's from the current's children, and then checking if it is null. If it is, then putting into the map, and then calling insert recursive function again. Let's look at the search. Search also is a search iterative and search recursive. In search iterative, we are looking if this word exists in this try or not. So again, current becomes root. Again, we iterate through all the characters in the word. Then we get the node for the current's from the current's map. We check if this character exists or not. If this node is null, then it means that this character doesn't exist in a map. And then we instantly return false. Otherwise, current becomes node. And in the end, we just return current's end of word. So if this word exists in the map, then this current end of word should be true for this word to exist in the try. And similarly, the recursive version is exactly same as the iterative version. And finally, we have delete. So we are trying to delete this entire word. So this is the recursive version. So we first call delete with root, word, and index 0. So we check if index has reached the word length. If it has, then we check if current is end of word. If current is not end of word, it means that this word does not exist in the try and will not delete anything. So we return false. Otherwise, we set current end of word as false, and then we return true if the current's map is empty. Otherwise, we return false. And this we are returning to give an indication to the calling function that they can delete this reference from their map. So this is the if we reach index's word length. Otherwise, we get the character, and then we get the node for that character from the map. If node is null, it means that this word, it does not exist in the dictionary. The word we are trying to delete does not exist in the dictionary, so we instantly return false. Otherwise, we call this recursively, and should delete current node will return either true or false. If it is true, it means that you got to remove this mapping from the children's from this current's map, and then return true if the size of the map for the current is 0. Otherwise, return false. So this is all I have to talk about try. Please like this video, share this video, comment on this video. Check out my Facebook page and check out my GitHub link. Thanks again for watching this video.